It had been a long, tough case so far. But finally, Spike and I had our man within reach. Salutations, Spike. Spike! You can do it! Just a little while longer! Just hang in there, Boss Monkey Man. The fate of an American Eagle family depends on you. Say, I know that smell. Not you. Worse, too stinky for even a flatulent moose. No, what I'm smelling's gotta be... Griffin! Think, Ace. You've got to make a decision now. Spike's little monkey life depends on it. Alrighty then. Here we go. Don't be scared, little Eagle nuclear fan. Ace is in the place.
Bye-bye, then.
Her expressions are so darn cute. So that's where I put my electric eels. You know, Spike, it's an ugly sight when Jell-O goes bad. Eww. Just had this baby installed, Spike. Should fool old Shiki for a while.
Loser.
Pet Detective Motto number 74. Who knocks on my door asking for money instead of offering money must be messed with. He's hot. He's bothered. He's shaking hands, 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 hands. Landlord from the bowels of hell. And speaking of bowels, how are the old bagpipes? Did I ever mention the bathroom walls are very thin? BMTV presents a very special event. Shaking Ants Unplugged.
I want the rent, Ventura, or I'm pulling the plug on you.
Obsessing on money just isn't healthy, Mr. Shrieked Ants. So just this one month, I'm gonna pay the rent in oatmeal cookies. They're high in fiber and may help you with your little problem. Think it over.
You're a very sick man, Ventura.
Then you better leave before you catch something. Take care now. Bye-bye then.
Hey, Manilow, got that info you wanted?
Lay it on me, Master Microman. I'm all ears.
Here's that story, Manischewitz. Eskimos are reporting the mysterious disappearance of all their sled dogs.
An ace case if I've ever heard one. Hippie of the microchippy. Let's went!
I'm way ahead of you, boss, but there are no ships going to Alaska this week. But I can drop you on an Alaska-bound ship that's already 2 days out to sea.
Just what kind of drop we talking about? Come back! Best two out of three! Hello! Don't leave me! Don't! I am not an amphibian! I am a human being!
Hey, Spike! Either our fall ruptured the time-space continuum, causing us to hurl back in time to the gay 1890s, or that sub is Captain Nemo's 100-year-old Nautilus. Let's check it out, sea monkey! Come on, Spike! Last one in's a rotten egg. And speaking of rotten eggs, are you making whoopee? Cushion?
Way, go in there. Never, ever, ever, ever! Now let's run silent. But whatever you do, don't run silent but deadly. How did you find us? Ah, out of the poop chute and into the fire. Next time, we don't leave home without pine-scented air freshener.
I, Jean de Monquet, am the only man worthy to succeed Nemo as captain of the Nautilus. Every creature in the deep will soon be my slave, and I will rule them with an iron fist.
Jacques de Monquet, ex-ocean documentary TV host who got the network axe because the Nielsen families could not understand a word he was saying. Current scourge of the seven seas and no friend of marine life who still hasn't figured out that elocution lessons are now available on books on tape. How lovely to see you again, Jacques, you crusty old bottom feeder, you. I see you're still a few guppies short of a full aquarium.
Feast on the sea's bounty, mon ami. Archangel fish from southern Atlantis. Diamond shrimp found only in the neap tide on the island of Rartopia. Ho-ho! Mollusks from the trenches of the Octavian Crescent.
Armand, speak to me! There's no pulse. He's gone. We'll have a burial at sea. Armand would have wanted that. You're serving a lovely dinner of death, Jacques?
I see you don't digest denizens of the deep.
You got that right, frog breath. Besides, this is the wrong wine.
But they are such delicacies.
Yeah? Try spelunking through your poop chute sometime. What you see may help you make the switch to whole grains.
Ew!
Well, this is really super fun. But Spike and I have a previous engagement. But it can wait. Right, Spike?
While you're my guest, Monsieur Foofy Hair, you will follow my rules. Locked doors stay locked. Going on the lower deck is forbidden. But feel free to frolic outside. I think you will find it quite wet.
Oh, the inhumanity! I will avenge you, Finny friends, and make the ocean safe for your children. One day, all shrimp will be free to grow up to be, jumbo shrimp. Marie Nemo, chief benefactor of the Great Sponge Uprising of 1846. Jean-Claude Nemo, inventor of the fish stick. Uh-oh. Two cavities. Someone has not been brushing. Maps. Just what we need. We can make origami. It's your favorite, Spike. The lovable fuzzy koala bear. Indigenous to Australia, where it lives in eucalyptus trees and feeds on throat lozenges. No centerfold? Bummer! And so I, Jacques Dumonquet, found the fabled Nautilus with which I will rule the seas. Captain Nemo's corners I have left untouched, just as the great adventurer left them a century ago. Today I explored the waters outside the ship and found a shell of the palest purest blue. C'est magnifique! Today I accomplished the impossible. I made roast duck from eel droppings. Just another day at the office for my personal hero. Mwah! These scrawled numbers, what can they possibly mean? Aside from the obvious fact that Jacques Dumonquet has the bends, I mean. Yeah, right! Ah, très magnifique. No? A modern invention. The cellular phone. I wonder if it dials out. Hello? King Neptune? Hello? Hello? Nope. Alrighty then. After you. Are you gonna make me tell the penguins at home that our big boss monkey man is a big boss wuss? Don't worry. If you're not back in 5 minutes, I'll just wait longer. Spike? 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 Oh, Mimi! I just love what you've done with the place. It's so positively scary. Lions and tigers and bears, oh my! Lions and tigers and bears, oh my! B-I-N-G-O, Volcano was his name. Spike? Got me! Sleep with one eye open, Hairball. Spike, you are a genius. I don't think so. A baby Belanoptera musculus, or whale, for all you non-Latin-speaking simians. DeMonkey's been netting whales. Hear that, boss monkey man? The plaintive wailing of, well, whales. There's more where this baby came from, and I'll bet if we release baby, he'll lead us right to Volcania. Who dares to intrude on my ship?
Who are you?
Captain Nemo!
Nemo? It is not possible.
You dare doubt me, little man? Observe as I navigate my rightful vessel with a flick of my hand. Die. Now, ride.
Bah! Parlor tricks!
Then dive with me again. Then dive with me again! I will take you to the depths unknown to man, where the immense pressure will crack your skull like a crab dinner! But that's not all. Your eyes will bloat like blowfish. Your spine will jiggle like jellyfish. and your toenails will pop like... little popping things.
You wouldn't. You wouldn't kill us all.
Wouldn't I? I'm already dead. Welcome to my world, baby.
Nemo, no more. Spare me. I'll do anything. Anything.
Anything?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Go to your room, into bed. Lights out, mister. No supper.
Yes, Parker.
And don't forget to brush your teeth.
No, who's there?
Okay, make your changes. I'm listening. Gotcha. Choose a game, boss. Save confirmed. Safe and sound.
Ah, a navigation table. We need to get to Volcania. Destination, Volcania. Nurse, koala, please.
Mr. Sulu, synchronize all coordinates for Volcania. Warp factor 4. And Spike, set your scanner for medium range. To Volcania, engage.
Ace is on the case. I'm right behind you, baby. B-I-N-G-O, Volcania was his name. That's not gonna move. Pet Detective, coming through, people! Gonna save the whales!
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
all's well that ends well. Ah, the sweet smell of victory. A quick stop at the Maritime Home for the criminally challenged to drop off old Jockstrap. And Spike and I were headed home. With a small sum of green stuff for our friendly slumlord. Spank you very much.
Okay, make your changes. I'm listening. Choose a game, boss. Save confirmed. Safe and sound.
Nope. No power?
I want the rent, Ventura. I'm not kidding.
Loser.
No power?
Just had this baby installed, Spike. Should fool old Shiki for a while.
Loser.
Guess what day it is, Ventura?
Groundhog Day? No. Warthog Day.
Try Rent Day.
A bit too tame in here. Ah, much better. No power? I'm not touching that. Who? Yeah, right. Can't do it. Two can play Shika Dance's game. Perfecto. Nope. I'm talking cable unready. I'm not touching that. Who knows where it's been? So that's where I put my electric eels.
Not a problem. I can handle it. No sweat. Nope. Where can I put this thing?
Yes, I can, and it hurts. Swim, boys! Swim! The sound of progress. Music to my ears. I have gone electric. I am the appliance king. I can do anything!
Hey, boss, what took you so long? I've been trying you for hours.
Just a little power problem with chicken ants. Nothing an old private eye like me couldn't handle.
Gotcha. Anyway, I've been calling to let you know Captain Sam's done with the sub. She's all rigged for ice breaking. You can plow your way to those huskies toot sweet.
And how sweet it is. On my way, matey. I'll see you after the pooches bust loose up north.
Good luck, Ace.
Captain's log, stardate 23.9. After dropping off Jock at the nearest starbase, we set up in the commandeered vessel Nautilus as we attempted to reach Alaska. Science Officer Spike and I would be landing to begin our search for the missing husky.
Like a glove!
Woo! Do not go in there! Take me to your heater, and then take me to your leader. Hi there. Come here often. Ace Ventura, Pet Detective. Apparently you don't speak English. Problem not. I'll just communicate through the international language of the hula. Note the undulating motion of the hands. It's all in the wrists and the hips. Come on, shake those hips. Shake them. Don't be shy, Chief! And one, and two, come on! Of course, it helps if you have a large plastic hoop. Who's the smelly stiff?
This is my father, our chief.
I've come to help your people, well-rounded one.
Let us sit by the fire and talk.
Well, it's certainly getting warm, but I am here on business. Can you show me around?
I'm afraid it's not so simple. My father is most suspicious of you. To win my father's trust, you must prove yourself to him in our traditional way.
Very well then. Lead on.
To prove yourself, you must defeat our greatest tribesmen, or satisfy our most exquisite tribal maidens in the ritual act of nose rubbing.
Spike, if I'm not back in 5 minutes, it means I'm thinking about baseball. Are the dogs still missing?
And now begins the true test of an Eskimo male, requiring skill, bravery, and great physical power.
I should probably inform you. Spike, my monkey, will fight on my behalf.
Oh, as you can see, he's very capable.
You must construct the most magnificent totem pole from any 6 pieces you can find here. Use the right combination and win our chief's approval. Put the wrong sections together and... well, I wouldn't want to be you.
Alrighty then.
You have angered the gods. Lightning round.
So what's shaken besides my thermometer?
We woke up one morning feeling like we'd been drugged. Our huskies were gone.
Something stinks here. And it isn't just your month-old well-blubber deodorant. The scene of the crime? Yellow snow. I wouldn't recommend eating it, unless you're a professional. It's fresh. I thought you said the dogs have been missing for days.
But they have.
Spike, this is a crime scene. Now make yourself useful and dust for prints.
Please help us to find our huskies. We are helpless without them. You can track our dogs with this. The Arctic Avenger.
Ah. Nothing like putting the top down and freezing your buns off!
Wait, Ace. My father wishes you to have his coverings so that you might wear it and be protected against the cold winds.
Personal hygiene is not your father's strong suit, as is evidenced by his strong smelling suit. But it's either that, or bring new meaning to the word snowballs. Sorry, Yogi, but we're not doing it for me. We're doing it for the Huskies.
Thank you.
evacuated. Nope! No huskies here. Mmm! Half-eaten meaty meat bones. Yummy! Yummy! A mouth-watering confection, a vulcanized rubber with cream filling. I got 25,000 miles on my last set. Too gamey for me. No. That won't work. How sweet it is! Feel the power of those pistons firing, yeah! Alrighty then. That's not gonna move. Hello? Do you know where we might get some gasoline? Thank you! But we only use unleaded! Don't worry, Spike. We've got them surrounded. Alrighty then. You asked for it! Remember, Spike, if at any time you feel the need to pass bad monkey air, don't.
Stop, or we will shoot you very much.
You would shoot your commandant?
Commandant? We thought you were the enemy.
These dopes think we're still at war. Let's mess with their minds. Empty. Alrighty then.
Do not speak to your commandant in that tone. What is your name, soldier?
Private Slovic.
The first rule of war. Never give your real name.
And what is your name?
Snoop Doggy Dog.
The second rule of war. Never lie to your superior. Both of you, hit the ice and give me push-ups! Trudge across the tundra in search of gas for the Arctic Avenger, or seize command of the not-so-slow-looking Slotoonian Sidewinder. Gee, let me think.
Commandant, are you leaving? What about us?
The Cold War with hypothermia is not yet over. I will check back with you in 5 years, comrades. Until then, be vigilant.
Here's Johnny! Smell you later, old friend. I don't think so. It seems dust bunnies breed as fast as the real thing, Spike. Anybody home? Whoa! I hate bats. Yuck! Man, talk about bed bugs. Funny place to put the light switch. Funny place to put the light switch. 1, 2, cha-cha-cha. 3, 4, cha-cha-cha. Furniture, ladies' undergarments, appliances.
are not a husky. Yummy! And thank you very much. TV! Bring the beer and pretzels, Boss Monkey Man! I think it's Tundra Bowl Sunday! How cruel! And unusual. How cruel and unusual. What kind of sick human would think of such a thing? And while I'm asking the questions around here, why? No! Let's get down to business. Pooch prods disabled. Let's get down to business. I was hoping to activate the karaoke machine, but this will do.
Come to me, doggy friends!
Let's all raise our voices in song, little friends. Alrighty then.
Get along, little doggies. Return to your village
and sniff each other's butts in peace. I know there was more to this than huskies.
I'm tired of being right. I don't think so. Less talk, more action. Let's free the seals and call an Ace Ventura bonus round. That sucker's bolted down. Yeah, right. I love the smell of free baby seals in the morning. Come on, guys. Time to grease you up. If you get back in the water without your oars, you'll bloat like beach balls and sink like stones. Let's see. Body fat doesn't just vanish into thin air. Gee, a heart-shaped jacuzzi. Gravy! Barrels and barrels of baby seal oil? This disgusting cargo is worth its weight in gold! Fellas, I'm sure Odora won't mind if we have a little soak in her tub. There'll be a hot time in the old tub tonight. If you like dances with wolves, you'll love swimsuits with seals. There's room for everybody! No shoving! The monkey ride shotgun. It's in his contract. I don't know who he is, but I do know this. I never want to see him in a tutu.
Hold it right there, pal!
I'd be easier to shove square pegs into round holes. There you are. One wad of cash. Be smart. Invest in tax-free municipal bonds and sunflower seeds. I don't think so.
Bye-bye, then.
Her expressions are so darn cute. Just had this baby installed, Spike. Should fool old Shiki for a while.
Loser!
Look, Mr. Chicken Ants, no animals. You've had a profound impact on my life, as you can see for yourself.
There may be hope for you yet, Ventura, but here's the real test. Give me the rent.
Nothing would please me more than paying you the rent. So the fact that I'm not going to pay you is a bitter personal disappointment to me.
Loser!
That's not gonna move. I'm seeing things, or there's more to this webpage than meets my private eye. There's only one man who can help. Woodstock! I've been hanging 10 on Exotica's worldwide webpage, and I've gotta say, something smells fishy in the surf.
Hold tight, Man of War, connecting now. Let's take a look. Seems harmless enough.
Yeah? Connect up to my screen. Take my hand and step through the looking glass with me, little girl.
How'd you get that, Montavani?
I'm a stud muffin manual transmission, but I thought you knew that. Now just drag the feather icon onto the logo.
Switching back to me. Gotcha! Wow, good work, Ace. I have an idea where this is headed. Keep working on those icons, and I'm gonna try to get under this sucker and see what's going on.
I love it when you talk dirty. That sucker's bolted down. Not enough upper body strength. No. Not enough upper body strength. That's two. We're getting warmer. Warmer, too warm, feeling the heat, can't stand the heat. I'm bacon sizzling on the griddle. Climate controlled environment has been re-stabilized, Houston. I'm not touching that. Who knows where it's been? That sucker's bolted down. That's three! My spider senses are tingling. This webpage was spun by a very bad arachnid.
Go, man, go! You're doing a lot better than I am, boss.
What gives, hippie of the microchippy? Are you losing your touch?
Oh, this sucker's burning my fingers, Ace. They got so much security, I'm not having any luck getting into their server. Never been stuck this long before.
Oh? Or maybe you just suck at your job. This is looking more and more like an Ozzy Osbourne album cover. Not one of my favorite heavy metal performers, since he's been known to end his stage act biting the heads off chickens.
Way to go, man! Keep moving! Man, this thing's tighter than your wallet!
I don't think so. Woo! Do not go in there. Spike, look in the yellow pages under Exorcist. Back, underworld spawn! Eat hot holy water, Linda Blair!
Oh man, this is deep! A secret code-locked underground page! And you cracked it, Mannix! Way to go!
Thanks, Mantooth, but I'm not sure this is a nice place to visit. Look! Ground rhino horns, baby horn powder at $250 per ounce, monkey's paw, the perfectly exotic back scratcher. This is an awfully lovely webpage of death. Not to mention overpriced. I want to know who's supplying the webpage and who's buying from the webpage. I want their mothers' mothers, their father's mothers, their mother's fathers, the sons of the mother's fathers, stepsons, if any, their stepsons' stepsons. I think that would make them grand stepsons once removed. I will liberate their animals. Their animals' mothers, animals' mothers' mothers. I will make these twisted, heartless scum eaters grovel at my feet so I can teach them what loving an animal is all about, because, baby, this webpage is going down.
Whoa, Ace Man, your face is blue!
I think that's a record.
Ugh. Ace? Ace? Hey, man, lost you there for a minute. You okay?
Annie Am? Toto? I had a terrible dream.
No dream, Manchurian candidate. That page of destruction is real, online, and international. And stubborn. It wouldn't let me into its server.
I'll get you in there. I'm gonna stop these maniacs before they depopulate the entire animal kingdom. I'm gonna go to their place, wherever it is, and get you a link to their database. And then I'm gonna make them pay. Them and their mother's mothers, and—
Whoa, whatever you say, man. But how are you gonna find them?
Easy, Azusa. I'm not going to the spider. I'm gonna bring the spider to me by doing a little home shopping on their network.
Clever cogitating, Ace. When you get there, you gotta find their secret files and get them to me. We'll need direct access to their mainframe. If they have a satellite link, you'll have to reposition it before I can do my thing. I've got a link to a military sat. Here's the coordinates. You ready?
All ready then. Fire away.
247 degrees west, 120 degrees north. And you'll also have to connect their communications net to their main server.
Gee, is that all?
No, grab me some onion rings and a large lemonade while you're at it. Woodstock out. Hey, good luck, Ace.
Not enough upper body strength.
Thank you.
think I'll order a gallon of fresh seal oil. Out of seal oil. That sucker's bolted down. Baby whale blubber? Of course you're out of stock. I cleaned you out. I'll have to go with an evening wear combo cut from fur of black gorilla with hippo skin lining for those cold winter nights, bat head buttons, mandrel collar, and an elephant trunk inseam for that snug,
like a glove
fit. I don't think so. Of course, I'll need to be custom fitted in the privacy of my own home. You know, Spike, it's an ugly sight when Jell-O goes bad.
Ew.
A bit too tame in here. Ah, much better. Either Chicken Ants has had a sex change, or this is my lucky day.
They didn't tell me you were so handsome.
They didn't tell me either. If I'd known, I wouldn't try so hard with the hair.
I'm Vanilla Sunday from Exotica International. I believe you recently ordered a custom garment from us, Mr...
Chicken Ants. The name is Chicken Ants.
I'm head of private relations, and I've been sent to measure you, Mr. Chicken Ants. All of you.
I think you should double-check the inseam. It tends to expand and contract with heat.
I have everything I need. Allow 6 to 8 weeks for delivery of your custom suit.
Wait! You didn't measure my monkey!
For a suit? He looks like he'd make a nice pair of slippers.
Spike? Manners! That's what I meant. Measure him and my feet for a pair of little monkey slippers. I suggest anesthesia, which I do not happen to stock in my medicine cabinet for the untamed one. We'll have to do this at your place.
Exotica aims to please its customers, Mr. Chickadance. Would you accompany me to our headquarters in Bavaria?
How exotic. Give me a moment to pack my lederhosen, and we're on our way. Nice spread you've got.
I think it's called Bavarian golfing. The tailor will be with you shortly.
But when will I see you again?
Never. Or in a moment. Or always.
Survey says never. Ah! Holy Ed Gein's mother! I can't look. I'm weak. I am soft. I cannot live in such a dark, dark world. disgusting! A dugong lawnmower? Sure, the poor guys feed on seagrasses, but this is too much. Sheesh! To see a Philippine eagle reduced to this. To go from the tropical rainforests of the Philippines to somebody's rumpus room as a can and bottle opener. Oh, this is too much. The snapping turtle? An American freshwater turtle with jaws powerful enough to maul a person's hand. Turned into a coffee table with a built-in nutcracker? A paperweight made from a Queen Alexandra birding butterfly? The largest butterfly in the world, with a wingspan exceeding 11 inches. True, owls do have very acute sight and excellent binocular vision. But that doesn't mean that they make a great set of night vision binoculars.
Ew!
An eye no pest strip? Since this primate eats mainly insect larvae, I guess it makes for a highly ironical item for the hipster set.
Yosh!
A throne made from the skin of the endangered sea cow? The waterproof surface must come in handy during those wild parties where your guests forget to put up the seat. Talk about tacky. Sure, the brown hyena emits a sound most people associate with laughter. But isn't this a bit tasteless? Nope.
Welcome to Exotica International, Mr. Shigadance. Or shall I say, Ventura? I trust you had a pleasant trip and that Miss Sunday took care of all your needs?
All my needs? I have quite a fertile imagination. Mr. Lard-ass?
Thaddeus Lardus. At your service, Mr. Ventura. So, you've heard of me?
Yes, Fatty-us Lardus. International smuggler of all things endangered. And animal. You've killed many men, never been caught, and are rarely seen by human eyes. But when you are, you're quite the eyeful. In fact, are you sure you're just one guy? Looks like they'll have to bury you in a piano case. A grand piano case.
Ah, you're clever. But not that clever, Mr. Ventura. I've been anticipating your arrival. You see, you failed to use your password when you logged onto the Exotica website.
And what is the password? Cellulite? Liposuction? Hindenburg? I love cheese? Oh, sorry. That's three words.
And secondly, we thought your selections were rather suspicious.
You're no doubt referring to the fact that I stomped all over your Alaskan and underwater operations.
Minor setbacks, I assure you. I have big ideas. Big operations.
I would expect no less from such a big man.
Mr. Ventura, I could squash you like a bug if I wished. But a man like yourself, exquisitely familiar with all the subtle nuances of the animal world, could truly appreciate what I've created here. Come, my castle holds many wonders. And here is my link to the world, Mr. Ventura. A marketing masterpiece. Behold, the stock market of the future! Before I'm through, every rare animal in the world will belong to me! What do you think of that, Mr. Ventura?
I think I wasn't listening. Say again, please. I think I wasn't listening. Say again, please.
Naughty, naughty! Tinkering with my equipment is a definite no-no, Mr. Ventura. Mr. Ventura, be a good little detective and try not to annoy me. I might get very angry, and you wouldn't want that.
What are you gonna do? Sit on me?
Now, now. If that device should fail, believe me when I say my response would be swift and personally painful.
You'd sit down really fast on a porcupine quill?
I meant personally painful to you!
Oh. I'm not touching that! Who knows where it's been? I don't think so.
I'd advise you to be more careful when you tamper with my toys, Mr. Ventura.
Fried to a crackly crunch.
My laboratory, where the animals are processed and their parts prepared for shipment, their precious oils turned into lotions and potions.
When they're in season, but it looks like a couple bumper crops got bumped. Yup, yup. Seal oil and baby whales are going to be very expensive this year, if you can find them at all.
Minor setbacks, I can assure you.
Minor? Odora was looking pretty bent about the mess I made at her factory, and old Jacques Dumonquet's probably still talking about the ghost of Nemo in his rubber room at Shady Acres. I'm good at my job. Very, very good.
Mr. Ventura, please stay with the tour. Bear cubs, worth their weight in gold. I sell their spleens for $5,000. Each paw is worth $1,000. $3,000 for a claw necklace. Mr. Ventura.
I'm sorry. You just got me wondering how much your buttocks on a stick would fetch. Please continue.
Now, in certain parts of the world, the bones of one tiger are worth $50,000. People believe eating the ground-up tiger bones gives them strength.
People also believe eating lard won't make them fat.
Mr. Ventura, please stay with the tour. How do you like my personal collection? Wagner himself was never surrounded by animals such as these sun bears and ibex, muskox and cheetah. You'll notice the acoustics in this cavern are the finest in the world.
Yeah, enough to make your ears bleed.
You are an annoying little man. Even if your knowledge and ability make you suited to appreciate the depth of what I have created here. Do you like opera, Mr. Ventura?
Love it! The beer drinking and accordions and polka till dawn? Oops. That's oompa. Opera. Opera. Oh, yes. Except for the unintelligible warbling and the cheesy costumes and the bombast and the sitting for 5 hours straight in lousy seats. Other than that, I love opera.
You will find me a bit of a zealot when it comes to my operas. I find the combination of great music and the scent of animal fear truly intoxicating. This concert hall, in combination with these rarest of animals, makes for quite a spectacle. Please, feel free to explore my menagerie.
The seldom-seen hellbender, contrary to its name, is not a drunken redneck looking for fights in bars, but a green-necked large aquatic salamander of the Ohio Valley region. The monk jack, native to southeastern Asia and the East Indies, better known as the barking deer. As such, it makes a great watchdog. The margay, a small American spotted cat resembling the ocelot and ranging from Texas to Argentina. Likes southwestern cuisine. Dislikes fat, sweaty men and fezzes. No. The king cobra. They can reach a length of 18 feet. They also enjoy the dulcet sounds of a well-played horn. I don't think so. Can't do it. Not enough upper body strength. No.
Let's put our cards on the table, Mr. Ventura. You're a pet detective who has trouble paying his rent. Aren't you tired of wasting your incredible mind and talents in the quest for household pets? You would never have to worry about money again. You could spend your days in search of the rarest creatures on the planet.
That's quite a generous offer. And after giving it a lot of thought, my answer is...
No!
Apparently, Mr. Ventura is not a man of vision. Take him to the guest room. Our opera will begin at 8, and I would strongly advise you have a different point of view by then, Mr. Ventura.
Oh, yeah? Well, let me strongly advise you not to leave so many sharp items lying around with guests in the house. Spike, samurai him. Spike! Hey, Spike! Get your hairy little monkey butt back here. Remember the new escape clause in your contract. I'll dock your salary. Are you a monkey or a mouse? Scaredy cat! Guess Lardis doesn't entertain too often. Yuck!
Going somewhere, Ace?
Vanilla, take me away from here, far away. A place where insane fez-wearing fat men never go. A place where it's always mating season.
Vanilla's got a scoop for you, Ventura. I work for Lardus and no one else. Got it? You've just been vanilla-shaked.
Yeah? And you're ugly! Don't look down! Do not look down! Say, baby, you're quite a dish. What do you know? Woodstock was right about the satellite situation. Guess he didn't lose so many brain cells in the 60s after all. Gotta change the coordinates for this baby. Move it or lose it. That sucker's bolted down. No. The communications room. This is it, just like Woodstock described. Time to patch things up and get out of here. Thank you.
What we got here is a failure to communicate.
But we can fix that. Let's see. We're looking at 247 degrees longitude, 120 degrees shortitude. Here it comes, buddy.
Live from the Fat Man's Castle, it's Saturday night with your host, Ace Ventura, Pet Detective.
No. Wow. Sometimes I amaze even myself. If only Spike were here to see this. Fly to Spider. Fly to Spider. Come in. Spider, this is Fly. I'm all zipped up. And your deep dish is ready to serve. Over easy and out. Detective motto number 4. He who gets caught does not beat the bad guy. Oh, you mean this isn't the rumpus room? Gee, I had my heart set on playing Candyland.
Comfortable, Mr. Ventura?
Really?
I must go. I mustn't miss the opening fanfare of my opera.
Tell you what, I've reconsidered your offer. Sounds like a great deal. Now release me and show me where to sign, okay?
It's too late. My offer has been retracted.
In that case, I hate to spoil your little Pagliacci party, but I'm afraid I've copied all your files to the internet. You see, at this very moment, your database of death is in the hands of authorities all over the world. There's nowhere you can run, nowhere you can hide your mangy hide. Stick a fork in you, Fateus, because you're done.
A minor setback, Mr. Ventura. Let your precious authorities come. All they will find here is a very dead pet detective. You see, I'll simply relocate my headquarters and animals in the morning. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have an opera to enjoy. And it is time for you to die. Start the laser! And now, Act One! Curtain rises on peril. Farewell, Ventura! Rest in pieces!
Yeah? I hope the sound of my dying scream spoils the aria for you. Well, Spike, nice to see you. True, you weren't around to help me, but as that laser begins to carve me into bite-sized chunks, all that counts is that you have lots of monkey fun. Now get me out of here. Thank you, Spike. But for all the grief you've caused me, no TV for a month.
I'm sorry. There is something I must attend to.
Spike, you didn't! Spike, Spike the caviar. Look, Spike! Costumes! The roar of the grease paint. The smell of the crowd. Spike? Spike! Good thing I'm a master of disguise. Stay out of sight, monkey head. Time for my debut.
Hark! I hear the sound of thunder.
La 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 la.
La la.
No great tenor sings out his butt. You're Ace Ventura!
At your service, Miss Sunday.
You're mine, little man.
Old buddy, nice to see ya. Wanna lend a hand, monkey friend of mine? Spike! My sweet, sweet monkey pal! Care to lend a hand? Can't do it. Hey, Spike, old buddy! Nice to see you! Yes! Yes! Way to go, Spike! No. No.
Die, Ventura! Die!
All right, fellas, let's go! Any day now. This is a rescue. The next creature you see in a cage will be you, the common jailbird. You're so darn big and pompous when you're mad. Actually, you're always big and pompous. Since we're playing with laser technology, mind if we listen to my new CD? Here's your irony, fat boy. You're the animal who's about to become extinct. And I do mean extinct. I got a whiff of what you did back there. And it really stinked. Hey! You could put someone's eye out with that! Or remove an unwanted cataract, which I do not have. No!
Die, Ventura! Die!
See you later!
You haven't heard the last of Tarzan's Lardus!
That was it. I just saw the biggest case of my career. Nope. No animal in me is beyond the grasp of Ace Ventura Pet Detective. Dang, I'm good! Alrighty then.
I ever go.
Ace Ventura.
See the man walking down the street. He dances to a different beat.
Ace Ventura.
He's got a slick back black jack. Give him all a heart attack. Go run, better run, still he's gonna get you some.
Detective on the run,
saving pets is number